Candies explode, radioactive vases and poisonous medicines.
Sounds crazy, but these are the silent killer hiding in cupboards, in the kitchens. They were put in the living room. They were part of the dyes, which is processed tissue in the homes of Victorian England.
Common household items deadly threat.
Now in the Leeds Museum you can admire some of them. Of course, the exhibition is organized with all the precautions, so that health visitors are not threatened.
Look at this ornament for a dining table. Good, isn't it? As it contains uranium oxide, a radioactive substance added to glass to achieve the then fashionable shade of green. Next, extinguisher production 1910.
Of course, the idea was to make the house more secure.
In fact, these extinguishers contain toxic substances, which constituted a particular danger in enclosed spaces.
Inside this elegant fan of feathers hiding a small stuffed bird.
Apparently, the authors of the fan put a scarecrow there for beauty. However, the Victorian taxidermists widely used arsenic and mercury, so that even to touch the bird was fatal.
Just look at this cylinder, made somewhere in 1840.
The fact that hatters the mid-19th century was used for processing felt by the nitrate of mercury. This substance can lead to serious heavy metal poisoning, which in turn can cause aggressive behavior.
Not hence the English proverb, mad as a hatter, mad as a hatter. Curator of the Museums of Leeds Kitty Ross said that the threat was not just a few things to adults, but toys, then was full of toys that did not meet modern standards. Children could choke on or get hurt on the sharp ends. In addition, many were painted with paint containing lead, or even made of lead. But these mints in 1880 eyes was intended to relieve sore throat.
However, they were made from potassium chlorate, which has a tendency to ignite spontaneously. Those who used them risked being much more sick than before. Taking this analgesic tin can in the middle is a lemonade powder that is sold from home and colonial stores. At first glance, God himself told me to mix this powder with water in that enamel pitcher.
But it would be a big mistake. Death could lie in wait for potential victims even in sweets. In 1858, the student pharmacist messed up the banks and instead of sugar substitute put the candy manufacturer arsenic. Unsuspectingly pastry stuffed with arsenic, a large portion of candy.
As a result, about 20 people died and hundreds were acute poisoning, although, fortunately, survived.
Today we all know that smoking is injurious to health.
But Portsigar made in the 1920s, written in golden letters the following message, problem from dawn to dusk. Sit down, rest and have a smoke.
You just wouldn't believe the crazy medicine out of the hands of the Victorian pharmacists, and even after pharmacists began to receive patents for their discoveries, and began to actively promote them, says Stella Barclay.
One medicine is called medicine soothing Mrs.
Winslow was intended for young children, so they quickly fell asleep.
Meanwhile it contained morphine.
So the kids, of course, fell asleep. There was cases when they have not woke up.
Moreover, in many Victorian powders contained arsenic.
Who would have thought that the pale face was threatened with a fatal outcome?
This powder often caused ulcers. They were covered with an even thicker layer of powder and it became a deadly circle.
In the early 20th century enjoyed widespread popularity, Air Tonic, the liquid that is recommended for use when the hair begins to thin and turn grey.
It contained lead as a poisonous and flammable kerosene. Modern home is a much safer place, says Ashley Martin from the Royal Society for the Prevention of Accidents.
However, you should not relax.
Over the past century in our notions of security and in trade regulations have been tremendous changes, he says.
But this process is not stopping, and what we think today is absolutely safe, may later turn into big problems.
It is clear that it is absolutely impossible to make our home completely secure.
According to Ashley Martin, every day we put ourselves at risk, when just down the stairs.
Annually in Britain, about 6,000 people die in accidents at home.
Many substances that we use at home is potentially very dangerous, if it is wrong to use them and do not follow the rules of their storage.